Amen.
Enduring to keep the unity of the Spirit, the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. Verse 4. I want you to count the ones here. All right? There is one body, one Spirit, even as ye are called into one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all of you. Did you see something there? That's completeness, right? Or perfection. You suppose Paul knew what he was doing when he just penned that stuff down there haphazardly? You think he figured something out? He might have been onto something? Let's read 11, chapter 4, verse 11. And he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come into the of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature and of the fullness of Christ. Whew! That's huge, isn't it? So why do we have so many churches? If there's one faith, one baptism, one God, Father, all. I mean, why so many churches? Pardon me?
Different one.
Different opinion. There's a strong one. Why don't we just focus on one part of light, okay? Be it whatever we want it to be. And then we'll just build a whole church around it. Or let us just call it nothing. We'll just bring it all in. Right? Let's go back to Amos. You guys leave something there so you can find it quick. Amos chapter 9. 9. In verse 9. You there?
Yeah.
For lo, I will command and I will sift the house of Israel among all nations, like as a corn is sifted in a sieve, yet shall not the least grain fall on the earth. Skip over to 13. Behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that the plowman shall overtake the reaper, and the treader of grapes, him that soweth seed, and the mountains shall drop sweet wine, and all the hills shall melt away. Is that a beautiful promise? Turn your Bible to John chapter 9. I'm wrapping this thing up, you guys. John chapter 9. John chapter 9 and verse 4. You there? I must work the works of him that sent me while it is day. The night cometh when what?
No man
can work. All right, turn your Bibles to 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians, this is where I'm going to finish. 2 Corinthians 6 and 17. You there? 6 and 17. Wherefore come out from among them. We've already read this, but I want to read it again. Wherefore come out from among them and be ye separate, saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you, and will be a father unto you. And ye shall be my sons and daughters, saith the Lord Almighty. Having therefore these promises, dearly beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God. When God makes distinctions between something, when God calls something unclean, who has the authority to take away that distinction? Who has the authority to call something clean that God has called unclean? There is only one deceiver of the people, and he seeks to blur the lines. He seeks to take away any divisions that people may have so that we can all just come together. But there's going to be a coming together of the false gospel, brothers and sisters. It's going to look real close to the real thing. But you know, if you're not studied, if you're not in the Word, if you're not in Christ, if you're not spending time with Him, you will be deceived. You will be deceived. There's been many of people deceived that never dreamed they could be. Good people. You cannot stand on your own, brothers and sisters. None of us can. Jesus didn't stand on His own. Did He? Did Jesus stand on His own?
No.
He sought the help of His Father in everything that He did. He didn't allow anything, no matter how many things were put in front of Him, because you know the devil threw everything that he had at Him. You mean from the very time He was born? Can you imagine? None of us has been tested or tried like that. None of us have been tempted like Christ was. He has made it easy because He blazed the way. He blazed the way. He's given us the Holy Spirit to lead us and direct us. Now we don't just have somebody that can be standing by us, but He's promised in us to lead us. Brothers and sisters, there should be no divisions in this church. We have to be of one mind in belief and doctrine. The Bible says, Isaiah 8:20, to the law and to the testimony. If it speak not to this, there's no light in it. Correct? That's a tough scripture, but it's true. God wants to bless us. He wants to come and wrap this thing up. So if we're faithful and following Him, we can go home. But we're not going home, brothers and sisters, until there's unity. So if you're sitting on the bus and you're not happy with the person you're next to, it's time to get happy. You know what I do when I have a struggle with somebody? Because my attitude is, I'm a type A personality, and some people don't take that real well. So I just have to pray, Lord, help me see this person like You see them. And you know, they don't change. They never change. But God changes me.
Yeah.
He changes me. And now I can love that person like I never even dreamed possible. And I'll tell you, it's a lot easier to love somebody, even if you're in disagreement with them. You know? If you've got some person that's way out there, you can still love them. You can still love them. God has a work to do in us. This church should be on fire, brothers and sisters. I seek and aim and prayfully desire that we get that way. Hand in hand. Just imagine this is a big old church bus, brothers and sisters, and we're riding into heaven. We're all going to be happy together. Okay? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Our closing song is 618.
Stand up for Jesus, He's so generous.
race is over and we're in heaven and you're looking back, I want you to think about that today as we go on the rest of the day. I just want to plant this seed in your mind. The thought that, you know, when I was down there on earth, I wish I would have done what? A little more. I wish, you know, it's like when a person comes to the end of their life. They never say, boy, I wish I would work more. Right? What is important to you? What's going to be important to you in the hereafter? You know, when Christ comes and he serves you, he's giving you this crown. I want you to think about what we're doing here today. What we're doing while we have this time on earth. Because someday you're going to look back, and are you going to be proud of what we did? What we thought, what we said, where we went? Or are you going to be ashamed? Brothers and sisters, today is the first day of the rest of your life. Let's walk out these doors changed people. We have the promises of God before us. We can march like an army with banners. We can be united. Let's let opinion drop by the wayside and follow Christ right into the most holy apartment of the sanctuary. Amen?
Amen.
Dear Heavenly Father, we want to thank you so much for this glorious day. We want to thank you for this high and holy Sabbath day. And it is my prayer that today is the day that these people have heard the worst sermon they've ever heard in 2018. Lord, I pray that this just keeps getting better and better, and that we would be united in Christ, looking to you for all of our sustenance, praising you for the promises that you give, and believing every word, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.